main event for rain is going to be this cold front back here to the west. Low pressure to the north there. A lot of snow still up into the upper Midwest and into the Great Lakes. We're going to see this severe weather action here move into the panhandle tonight, overnight, and then down the peninsula tomorrow. And by tomorrow afternoon through tomorrow evening and night, that's when our threat for strong to severe storms will be there. And Storm Prediction Center has put us in the level two here, slight category for most of, if not all of, the peninsula for tomorrow as that line of strong storms will move on through. Now, what are we talking about? We're talking about wind, 50, 60 plus mile per hour winds, which could be damaging winds. A lot of lightning. Lightning's the number one weather killer here in Florida. Tornado threat and hail threat, they're not zero, they're slight. We could have the chance to spin up a couple of tornadoes. We did the last time. We could see a couple of them this time around too. So let's time it out hour by hour on ViperCast here. We're starting off. We'll have a couple of rounds here is how this is going to work. The first round is going to happen in the middle, early part of the afternoon, and that's going to be well out ahead of the line of showers and storms. We could get some of these storms to form from the sea breeze and then push back towards the coastline very, very quickly. With that, the coverage is only going to be isolated, though, so not everybody's going to see round one. In that, though, we could see an isolated tornado. There's going to be some rotation, some shear around for that. Hail is a possibility, too. It's going to get to 90 degrees. A lot of that warm air rising very, very quickly. Gusty winds and lightning with that, too. And then round two comes, and the timing of that, say 8, 9 o'clock or so. Now, this has been sped up from earlier, too. And with that, we could see some damaging wind gusts, lightning, heavy rain, and that will be more widespread. A lot more people are going to see this round too. And then as we get towards the overnight hours, all this may converge over central and southern Palm Beach County there, right around 11 o'clock midnight or so. Then after that, say 1, 2 o'clock, it's gone. By Monday morning, cold front moves on through. We see clearing skies Monday through the day, breezy and cooler. That lasts all the way into Tuesday, too. Tuesday morning, we're going to be in the 50s, and some folks may even see some 40s, too, some outlying areas. The wind is going to make it feel cooler, too. It will be very dry with low humidities, too. If you want to stay abreast of everything, download our WPTV mobile app here. You can get the interactive radar on the screen there and know when it's coming. If the sky's darkening, just open it up, look right at it. Push alerts will send you when the danger is coming. We'll send you some push alerts and live streaming video. If we happen to go on air wall to wall here and it gets really bad, you can just tune in right on your phone. And of course, local forecast, see what the weather's going to be like afterwards. Hour by hour forecast here again in the morning, maybe a cloud or so. Then we'll see some sunshine. Shoot those temperatures way up to near 90 degrees. Then we'll see the chance for a few showers, thunderstorms, isolated at first. And then as we get later, like dinner time hour later, that's when we'll see more widespread showers and storms. Then the temperatures take a tumble. We're talking the upper 70s for highs for a few days. And also the humidity takes a tumble too. It'll be real humid tomorrow. And look at that. We drop down to dry on Tuesday. And then we go slowly back up throughout the rest of the week. Small craft advisory tomorrow sees 4 to 6, occasional 8. So it'll be real choppy out there. Beach forecast, you may be able to squeeze in a few hours in the morning. Just keep in mind you're in an open place. Thunderstorms may quickly approach you throughout the day. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday all look fantastic with low humidity, highs in the 70s, lows in the 50s and 60s.